Already, my friends, because we have started on time for the first time in miraculous number of years. I reached my hotel, I checked in, I made sure that the internet speed was good, and it's good, and we're good to go. This is an exciting moment for India as a country. I think India can celebrate this moment. This will be one of the defining moments, and especially on October 2nd. You know, it's a beautiful day to celebrate India. And the fact that this miraculous thing has been achieved. Many things to discuss. First of all, was that a catch? Was that a catch? Did Graham Swan also almost die of a heart attack after that catch? Did Gautam Gambhir and Graham Swan agree on something? Can KL Rahul reach brilliant knocks and finish the match? Is this achievable for him? Or does he just like to ensure that all the rest of the people are in a good mood? And another question, how much will Venkatesh Iyer get for the IPL auction? Is it going to be $12 billion or is it going to be the entire GDP of Cuba? We also have to discuss Lockie Ferguson. Is he a batsman? Because that's what KKR thinks. And also, hilarious dismissals. We also have to discuss another thing. Is Morgan better than Dhoni? And all of that stuff. And another thing, there's so many things to discuss. We'll discuss the Ashes. We'll also discuss the Indian women, should they have declared, should they have not declared, many things to go. Shri Vats N says, Saurabh, can you give a shout out? The answer is, no, I will not say Shri Vats is a shout out to you, which is a shout out in itself. Do give a like so that more people join in and algorithms can be defeated, because at the end of the day, algorithms must be defeated because we must conquer the machines. Okay, as humanity, we must conquer the machines. Okay, what are you wearing, says Manan Bhatt. This is a cat t-shirt. It's amazing. My daughter loves it, and so I love it. That's how things work. There's a, I know I'm melding into the background. A great start, man. I think I've lost my mind. This is what happens when you land and go straight into a live. Okay, I have to say, first off, please get it ready. Have to thank some of our sponsors. We have a sponsor today. Very excited about this. We have Cuckoo FM as a sponsor, which is India's leading vernacular audio podcasting platform with a content library of 1,000 hours of content in different regional languages. You say, Saurabh, that's correct, Saurabh. Absolutely right. I, by the way, went through Cuckoo FM. I was actually supposed to do some work with them a couple of years back at my schedules didn't match because, you know, I'm a very busy person. Since we're on the IPL, I listened to a book which is called The Indian Paisa League, which is quite interesting because I'd forgotten one very simple fact about that T20 World Cup in under Dhoni. India, as a rule, were not taking T20 very seriously until we won that, right? Like, it was quite interesting because if we hadn't won that, maybe the IPL wouldn't be as big as it is right now. So that was, I think, quite interesting. They also have some great horror and thriller stories. I listened to one called Bhuto Ka Restaurant, which is like, oh my God, it's great fun. Very like old school stuff, completely enjoyed it. And they also have, which I thought was really fun, which is summaries of famous motivational books. So they had a Hindi edition of Subtle Art of Not Giving a F asterisk CK. What does the asterisk stand for? Maybe it stands for obliques. Comedy content number one. There's also a lot of podcasts, etc., etc. And while going through the whole thing, I realized that I really should do a bad comedy book in my broken Hindi. I will pitch this to Cuckoo FM and make more money from them. So anyway, Cuckoo FM has given a discount for today, which is on Gandhi Jayanti. It's Gandhi 50 is the code. From 1st to 3rd October, subscribers get 50% off on the annual subscription of $3.99. And if you want to support the show, then you can also get a lifetime 20% discount on the same using code SP20, which is for Saurabh Pant or Sanu Penon, whatever you want to choose. So give a OP to our sponsors. They're very nice. Okay, Amre, let's get back to this. Amrita Ravi Mohan says, your shirt is so shiny. It's genuinely very shiny. You know what? Usually when I'm sitting in my house, I can turn off, reduce the light, but I'm sitting in front of the sun. So I can't reduce the light and the sun. If anybody from ISRO can help out, please let me know. Aditya Pacharne says, my God, the comedy is transcending the space and time. Completely agree. Teja Surya says, since CSK has already qualified, will Raina be rested today? I don't think so, dude. They need him back in form. Shitish Sharma keeps putting out this thing that says hashtag K9. I don't even know what that means. Also, if you're in Delhi, I'm going to be performing in Delhi tonight. I'm going to be at Happy High at 6 p.m. and I'm going to be at Helium Comedy Club at 9:15. So please come if you want to come for that. Tomorrow, I'm going to be in Gurgaon, Piano Man at 4 p.m. and then I'm doing 7:30 at Furball. So yeah, tickets are on saurabhpant.com. Next week is Hyderabad. Okay, enough of me talking about stuff. Amrita Ravi Mohan says, turn off the sun, Saurabh. I will try. I will speak to the Simpsons writers because they tried that once. Okay. Talking about people who are like the sun, people who remind me of sunshine with their joyful behavior and absolutely zero sarcasm. A comedian of note, one of the leading cricket commentators in the world of cricket. She's not on Hotstar, those like me. So please give it up for Anuradha Menon. Good evening. Good evening, madam.
Anuradha, you know, only my teachers in school used to call me that. I used to feel very nervous. They said Anuradha, I knew that, you know, I was in trouble. And I was very rarely in trouble, na, Saurabh, because I was top three students. Stop it. Obviously, I was a full nerd. Why do you think whenever, you know, there are South Indian nerds in the cricket team, I get so happy. I was like, yes, my people, you understand. And everyone is going on about Venkatesh Iyer's degrees. I was like, but that's normal. Like, why are you surprised by this? That's why South Indians are so goddamn smug the whole time. Because we always have these great educational qualifications. I mean, I did drama, but it's a master's in drama. You understand? It's always...
By the way, I've forgotten to start the recording, so I'm going to start the recording. You know, because now we're recording in progress. Thank you, madam. So one second. So you did a master's in drama.
Yeah.
Wow, man. Did you have exams for that? Did you have like the first question?
Did a little thesis and all we did. We did. You could choose your topic, study. Yeah, yeah, we did all this. But there's also a vocational thing. No, we are climbing imaginary mountains, wading through imaginary waters, breathing through our bottom. You know, regular drama school things like that.
Breathing through your bottom is a regular drama.
Yeah, it's a technique. I haven't mastered it because I think the size of my Malayali bottom always got in the way. Now, whatever. What is to be said about aesthetics?
Yeah, so basically Ace Ventura is the ultimate expression of masters in drama.
Sure.
Yeah, I'm just saying that, listen, that's what you could have achieved one day. what is your thesis about? What did you do a thesis about?
About Henrik Ibsen's plays.
Oh, I know Henrik Ibsen. He wrote a very famous play, which is...
Doll's House.
Yeah, I've read Doll's House.
Yeah, that one.
Yeah, yeah, I've read, that's the one I've read. So I could have done a whole this thing about the Doll's House. It has Barbie in it. Sometimes it has G.I. Joe.
No, the women empowerment, what women want. Should she have left the husband? Should she not? You know, this is very deep.
Oh, always leave the husband. I say that's a non-negotiable. Just leave the husband. Why stay? But yeah, I have, of course, done a master's in commerce where my thesis was how to do my master's in commerce. So I did it. So I passed.
At least I'm sticking to what I studied, Saurabh, in the vicinity of. This is the problem. Yeah, in comedy. And everyone says, oh, wow, he engineering chhodke comedy kar raha hai. But who, why has he wasted an engineering seat? I get no respect for sticking to what I studied. I didn't waste my money in IIT. And then say, nahi, mere ko comedy karna hai, follow my passion. But shit.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. So so what you're trying to say is that Venkatesh Iyer, rather than being celebrated for his degrees, should be derided. The people
not
say...
at all. Venkatesh Iyer should never be. Huh. Because I understand he's not doing comedy. But I just fail to understand why comedians have to get extra respect because they have left their high standing positions in order to see. Venkatesh Iyer is getting more respect because he did a master's in like an MBA in finance and CA, right?
Yeah.
Do you understand? But I'm just saying, can I also get a little bit respect because I studied drama and then I stuck to that same profession? Sorry.
Yeah, you should.
I'm bitter. Am I coming through as bitter? No, stop it.
And also, what we're doing right now is drama. This is all an act. This is a scripted play. This entire script I've sent to Anu, every word that's coming out of my mouth, including that last one, Ibsen Lovishmirk, is all part of the script. This is all written down. By the way,
listen, you can't talk about scripts and then that can't be your segue into speaking about the cricket. Just by the way.
By the way, I'm going to do this. I would love for somebody to search on Cuckoo FM if they have a Ibsen play. I'm pretty sure they might. So So see, this is a smooth plug for the brand. Okay, let's take a couple of chats that are popping. And again, you can do a super chat so that we can take it. Lots of stuff to discuss. Okay, let's talk about yesterday's match. I have a bunch of notes. Dude, I thoroughly enjoyed how Punjab Kings tried their level best to Punjab Kings, the Punjab Kings chase. And then KKR was like, nah, not interested. Let us make this even harder for ourselves. What did you think of the whole chase yesterday?
I just thought that KKR felt bad about that Punjab Kings versus Rajasthan Royals match and then decided, you know, in their moment of whether they get a tax deduction for charity, that this was their sort of donation, given their drop catches. And the fantastic catch they did get went against them. So it was like just one of those days, you know, where everything was just going against. So there's nothing you could do. And I've said this many times before. I don't know why I have never warmed to Owen Morgan as a person. I feel the polar ice caps won't melt if you just place him there. He is just so frigid. So I just find, that's just my opinion. I may be way off here and maybe he's full of the milk of human kindness, but I don't see it.
Yeah, I mean, let's not talk about milking Owen Morgan. That's a private matter between him and his partner, whoever they may be. But I would love, okay, now that we are on the topic of Owen Morgan, okay, this is his current average in the IPL. Like, I think you'll struggle to find somebody with a worse average after 12 innings in the, and I think he's batted pretty much every one of them. Average it's of 10.9. It's okay. By the way, you are not far off, okay, because he's got 10.9 as an average with a strike rate of 100.92. And all of this is basis 147 not out. So if you take away that 47 not out, his average is like about, I would say 6-11, like it's about 5.8. Like that's literally what his average is. And I'm like, can you imagine? And then over and above that, he essentially dropped the match.
Yeah, pretty much. Yeah.
But
he took account, like accountability was there. So therefore you're supposed to say, oh, yay, Owen.
Listen, but you never know. Maybe I don't know. Like, he seems like, I was listening to Mark Wood talk about him and he said that Owen Morgan is very calm and like he's one of those like really chilled, laid back, where he's like not really affected by stuff, which I think maybe you need in an international
is
side.
Is calm a euphemism for cold? Because there is a difference.
So you're not a fan. You're not a fan of Owen Morgan.
Not a fan. I feel like how you don't need the light with that shirt. You don't need the AC with Owen Morgan in Indian summers. He just has to speak and...
I think when Tim Southee, like in the last match, when Tim Southee was playing in the day, they put this one patch of ice pack on his neck. So you're trying to say it should have just been Owen Morgan. Somebody should have just picked up Owen Morgan and put him on Tim Southee to cool him down.
I just think that actually is a part of Owen Morgan. He just donated and it's an ice pack. Mera lungs le. Chal.
What is it about, like, okay, we got to break this down, okay? Because I think, like, I can't understand whether KL Rahul and Mayank Agarwal put way too much pressure on themselves. Hence, the rest of the side seems undermined, or the rest of the side is just sucks. And hence, KL Rahul and Mayank Agarwal, they put so much pressure on themselves. Because I have a feeling it's the first. I just think that they...
No, I feel they know the rest of their team sucks. Like, even when Mayank Agarwal got out yesterday, you saw his reaction, right? He got out at 40 or whatever. Yeah. And he let out, like, I think about 3 F words really loudly. Because he knows that if they don't go through or take them nearly across the line, that they're all going to fall like a pack of cards or whatever. Like, I think they know.
I don't know. I feel like they're really putting way too much pressure on themselves. Dude, first of all, I don't understand why they didn't place Shah Rukh Khan until now in the
second. Earlier?
Yeah, makes absolutely no sense. Huda has not been in
the best chose form. To bring Shah Rukh Khan against KKR, like just as a, what was it? Was it mind games? Like,
And by the way, I mean, Sunil Gavaskar said that Shah Rukh will be sad about disappointing Preeti Zinta. That's the line that Sunil Gavaskar said. So this whole match, and his whole selection was just for Sunil Gavaskar to say that.
I think Sunil Gavaskar gave him a lot of trouble for the things he says. He also said, basically that RR is more concerned about getting more followers on Twitter than about winning matches. So then the headline was, oh, this is what Chris Morris had to say in retaliation, and he reacted in this way to Sunil Gavaskar. So I was like, oh, what was the reaction and all? What is the reaction? Well, he's entitled to his opinion. I was like, chee, that's the whole article. I thought there was some fast bowler angst that was going to come out.
I think given how Chris Morris's record has been in the second leg, I don't think he has too much this thing. But dude, Sunil Gavaskar, I think talking about social media following, let's be honest, okay, 95% of anything that happens in the world right now is for cloud chasing, okay? Whether it's a cricket team or whatever, right? So Gautam Gambhir said that everybody's talking about the spirit of cricket because they're trying to gain social media followers. I'm like, yeah, but the reason you said that was because you also want to. Like, you're all doing the same thing. So this whole chasing clout and chasing followers is like everybody's doing it. I just think that this whole dismissal of whatever is quite absurd. By the way, Stijit, let's take a couple of chats. Stijit has said that Embuldenia OP also nice shirt, Pant. Absolutely. Thanks a lot. I keep forgetting that my surname is Pant and I read it as Pant like a psychopath. But yeah, I think that KL Rahul has done this so often where he's like, hey, I'm at the door. Okay, I'm at the door. I just have to ring the bell. And he's like, no, I'm going to slip and fall. Like, it's, he does this so often where I'm like, dude, you've reached the end. Just why are you trying to hit him? Like, I find it very, and he's a brilliant player, right? Even like his track record and all of that stuff. But he just seems to, at just that last moment, and I think he's just, again, putting way too much pressure on himself.
That's why he was standing at the boundary. He didn't move now when he went off. He was just there. Like, I think he was so nervous. It's like, shit, have we done this again? Oh, no.
Yeah, dude. Like, again, it's just, I actually think that Mayank Agarwal and KL Rahul need to have some, because you have Pooran, who has a great track record in international cricket. And I have a feeling that almost like you're communicating out to the rest of the team that, listen, we think you are not worth it. That's why we're so disappointed that we can't finish this off. And I'm like, dude, the rest of the side can manage. Shah Rukh Khan is, I think, like, even given how he performed at the Syed Mushtaq and all the rest of that stuff, he's a pretty good batter.
But Nicholas Pooran has not had a good season at all, whether in the first phase or the second phase. So I think, I don't know. I don't know if they should necessarily persist with him at number three. Given, and also, even with that previous, I forget who was RR playing their last match. They all just felt like a pack of cards. And my thing is, I understand it's T20, but at some level, use your brain a little bit, na? Why are you going for everything? There are two new batsmen in the crease and you still want to loft them. Like, calm down. Like, why don't you just play two balls patiently and then go for it? I don't know sometimes. Like, I don't know. It's very frustrating to watch.
Yeah, you mean entertaining. Like, I was yesterday's match, I was just amused by how, like, the kind of mistakes everybody was making. Like, it was just incredible. First of all, okay, let's just come back to KKR's innings for a second, okay? There were three dismissals that I genuinely laughed while watching it, and I watched the highlights again just to rewatch those. first Owen Morgan, I don't know how he got out, dude. It's such amazing proof of how that paddle or whatever, that scoop, whatever the shit that they play, when it doesn't come off, you look like such a such a twerp, okay? Like, he's moved his whole body and just left his leg there, where he's like, Shami, hey, can you aim for my leg? And I'm like, I think I could get you out of that. Like, you literally exposed your entire stump. I don't know what he was trying to do. And then Dinesh Karthik, he just does the same thing. Then Seifert does the same thing and then gets run out on the... I'm like, this is... Like, whoever is the paddle sweep coach, because I'm sure they have one now. That was hilarity. It was just ridiculous.
Hey, but Russell is out now for the rest of the IPL, right?
Is he? I don't know. Is he out for the IPL, for the whole thing? I don't know. I'm sure somebody in chat...
So, I mean, the last two matches I figured, because they were saying that it was quite a distinct injury. So, I don't know. You know, like, this is just off topic suddenly. But I remember, because Nadal always has a knee... He's always historically had a knee problem, a foot problem, right? And they said you can't play tennis at 19, and then he's had to change it. So, this ex-colleague from Channel V, who was a Federer fan, always used to tell me, "Haan, gaand itna bada hai, toh ghutno pe dard hoga hi." And it was so bad. But how much I laughed, because I was like, rude, but mildly funny and a bit true.
And by the way, she said "can't." She didn't say anything else. She said "can't." Just to clarify.
Yeah, that's
because this is a clean fucking show. Anyway, subtle art of not giving a f.ck is on the summary is on Cuckoo FM. Okay, I'm just saying that again. Okay, let's. There's a lot of theories coming out on Puran. Somebody says, Spandan Bhattacharya says, blonde Puran ain't the same anymore. I don't know if that makes sense. Yogendra P says, I think Puran's form is because of Punjab management. So who do you think it is? Do you think it's because of Punjab management or do you think it's because of Puran's barber? What has caused this dip in form?
I think you're giving Puran's barber a whole lot of credit with some superpowers there. If turning blonde, I mean, if anything, they say blondes have more fun and blondes have it better. So that theory is that. But if we're talking about management, I don't think anyone has mismanaged staff or player relations as much as Sunrisers, in my humble opinion. And let's talk about what's happening with little Dave Warner there. Yeah. You know, I never thought I'd see the day when I feel bad for a short Australian man, but I'm starting to feel a bit bad. So, yeah. Like this thing of not allowing him at the ground and all is too much. Clearly shit has gone down and badly. Yeah. The fact that I don't think he's also covered himself in glory by being public about his unhappiness regarding selections and tuckers with the owners and management and all of that. So I don't know if this is some sort of subtle passive aggressive punishment. Now you sit in the corner and be quiet, you know, kind of thing. And also, I don't necessarily feel it's a mistake for him. He's done it also very subtly, right, on social media. Why is, like, Twitter went up in arms? Because he replied to someone and they said, oh, we hope to see you soon. And he's like, oh, not this season. As opposed to making an announcement himself, he cloaked it very cleverly as a reply to someone's tweet. So, there's also other theories of how Jason Roy having played in England and under Trevor Bayliss. So that makes more sense. They have a good relationship, et cetera, et cetera. And not that Warner's been in great form either, but for someone who's always consistently been in and such a central, important cog in that batting wheel, it's like that Virat Kohli thing. No, we're not used to them not playing well. So when they do, we're like, oh my God, what the hell, you know? And I think the 2.5 times they've won without him also in the team. So at some level, they also look justified for the outside gaze, you know, in that sense.
Yeah, I mean, like, it's essentially, I think it's what Watson was saying, which is that when you drop someone and then you remove them from captaincy, the word that spreads is that, hey, listen, you could be next. And that causes you to go like, you know what, this is going to be a tough one. I don't see a big deal about him. I mean, again, I want to know the background because I'm sure there's got to be some conspiracy behind it. But I don't see the big deal about not allowing him on the ground, man. Let him sit at home and make taka-tak videos and whatever else he does and prepare for the World Cup. And I think that it's a great strategy because he's definitely still going to open for Australia in the T20 World Cup. So they're essentially ensuring that he just stays in the hotel and doesn't do anything else. So it's a good tactic, keeping the World Cup in mind. So this is, again, Kane Williamson, the master strategist, has decided that, you know what, you stay there and just you watch Netflix for the next 10 days. You can't get out of your hotel. Stick in your bio bubble. And that's what he's done. So I think Williamson is more evil than we thought, is my theory there. Okay, we have one super chat popping in from Saurabh Roy. Thanks a lot, he says. I might be completely wrong, but I somehow feel Morgan's approach to his batting is a little self-serving. Thoughts plus Seifert coming at 7. Well, I mean, all batting is self-serving, right? I mean, you're rarely batting for like anything else.
We want him to serve himself, help himself a little better. That's the thing. Serve yourself better.
Yeah. I mean, self-serving would be that Morgan is getting a buffet of runs, whereas he's being self-serving where he falls in the buffet. Where he takes the first...
Or drops the buffet.
He takes the first thing, which is kheer, and just throws it all over the thing and ruins the whole buffet. And then, dude, that drop catch, I was like, oh man, how... And by the way, you know what I've noticed? This is the third continuous match, I think, where KL Rahul has been dropped in the in single digits. Like, I think this is a habit. Yeah. The last match also he got dropped and then they almost won and then they didn't win because they are Punjab Kings. What do you think of that DK drop? The one where he just bailed out at the last minute?
I mean, I've just put everything down to it. Like, it's one. You can't call it. Yeah, it's just.
Yeah.
It's just what it is. You know. It's like, but yesterday the prize recipient, what I found really cute is because they kept showing that, you know, Venkatesh Iyer, I think, had won some most number of runs. You know, when I've lost track of the number of awards. You know, das bar saans liya, check of 1 lakh. You know, like that sort of. So I've just lost track. So he won about 2 awards, and this is Venkatesh Iyer. Oh, Venkatesh Iyer has won. Okay, and then cut to Mayank Agarwal for the most number.
Dude, I thoroughly enjoy. I think Kohli when RCB had started on a terrible note, and I think he had won the master striker of best human being in the world or some shit. He goes to receive his award, and Kohli is looking like he's about to weep. And they're like, "Congrats on this amazing award, being the best person to breathe in the most oxygen today." He's like looking miserable. I thoroughly enjoy it, dude. It's so humiliating to go up there and win these stupid awards that have no purpose except for.
But sports. Also, especially when the person who's conducting the post-match ceremony is Murali Karthik. I don't know whether he's insulting them or complimenting them. Or just because everything is a bit of both. It's just innuendo start to finish. Like, I feel he should be a soap opera writer. I was like, the amount of innuendo.
He does innuendo? I've not heard that, yeah.
Just, oh, you know, in spite of all those runs that you garnered in a losing cause. Like, just weird shit he's been like.
Yeah, I think my mortal enemy and your friend Abhijit Ganguly tweeted this, right? Which is that, actually, he's not my mortal enemy. My mortal enemy would be Atul Khatri. He's one of my enemies.
Atul Khatri? Because?
Just for comedic reasons. Just not a fan. Not a fan.
Of his comedy or the fact that he makes so much money with his comedy?
All of it. Like, I'm judging the audience. I'm judging him. Judging everybody. So Atul Khatri is my mortal enemy. Like, Atul Khatri is, this is the kind of dick he is, okay? So I release a stand-up clip and Atul is like, oh my God, go watch this hilarious clip from Saurabh Pant. And then he puts his own link of his own video. And he's like, oh, look, I did this. And I'm like, you fucker, I used to do this for you earlier. So now you're just taking vengeance on you. I used to do it on Kunal Rao for a long time. He used to keep doing this to Kunal Rao, which is one of the reasons the IC broke up. Anyway, so Atul Khatri is a piece of shit. That's all I want to say. Just want to mention that he's my, I'm SRH and he's my David Warner. Stijit says, by the way, I used to play with Tripathi and he's one of the purest souls. Dude, he seems like such a nice guy. Did you finally see him saying that, everybody, please, go get your COVID. It's important to do that right now. COVID is there and you must do it now because COVID is a problem. And it's so cute, man. He's so cute.
I have not seen it.
Yeah, it's he's very cute. I genuinely think that Rahul Tripathi is currently a better T20 batter than Shubman Gill.
On current form for sure now. Yeah.
Current form for sure. 150%. He is averaging 35, strike rate of 143. Throughout this 2021 season. And I'm genuinely a big fan of the guy.
And he and Venki Iyer have been also having a really good partnership in that sense. Yeah. In fact, the first time, remember, I think we discussed this last time. We felt that Tripathi should have got the man of the match over Sunil Narain. And I'm all for bowlers getting it. But, you know, I was like, come on. What a nice guy. Give it to him.
Yeah, he's so cute. Yeah. I just like him. By the way, I DM'd Ambati Raidu very excitedly yesterday. Just randomly. I don't know why I'm sending.
To say random, what?
Just like, dude, I just like Ambati Raidu as a player. It's, and also that.
After you didn't recognize him and you just feel guilty now, you're just sliding into his DMs like a pervert. Cheap.
Yeah, like, like a real pervert. And I've been sliding into a lot of cricketers' DMs these days. It's quite, and a few of them are responding with like, hey man, just like, I mean, it's like, thanks, Baba kind of stuff, but more like, just chill the fuck out, dude. I'll tell you what that Raidu and Bravo interview, that mini small interview that they did. I was like, this is so cute. Yeah. This is so
it is.
Both of them want to say way worse to each other, but they can't because it's on camera. And you see that this relationship is much worse than them. Like, in the best way possible, it's much worse. Like, they're much worse to each other. I was like, this is so cute. So, yeah.
You know, I was very worried when Dhoni came out to batter in that match against... make heavy weather of with against... Who were we playing last? See, things are blanking on now.
I don't remember now.
oh god, okay, whatever. So and I was like, oh crap, like Raidu's okay, but I thought he would send Jadeja. I honestly thought so. Because I was like, yeah, shit, we're losing wickets also in a hurry. I didn't see Dhoni come. Because that was, I think, also the criticism in phase one. That he was coming in at like number 8 or something, you know. Like way down. And, you know, as a captain, I was like, it's okay. He's not in form.
Yeah.
But then, of course, with that 6, all things were forgiven. All facts were forgiven with that winning 6.
Yeah. But yeah, Miss Dhoni, by the way, also have to update, Indian women declared on 370 for 8.
What was that?
I was surprised they declared. Why did they declare? Yeah. I don't understand.
I mean, they've lost time due to rain, which I get. So they want to make a match of it, which I also get. But mentally, you know, it's that thing of, you know, get to 400. You know, it's just a mental thing. And it's not like, I mean, Jhulan Goswami can bat. So it's not like, you know, she can't manage a few. And 377, I just thought was a... was a sort of, and they're already, when I saw last, they were what, 56 for 1. Hey, should we talk about nepotism in cricket? Isn't Alyssa Healy? Do we never talk about nepotism in cricket, or we just say, like, you know, how political families and all are there, like cricketing families? I always think that's quite cool. Yeah.
They're 69 for 2 right now. Jhulan Goswami has taken 2. Both wickets so far.
Okay, cool.
Yeah, because even I was surprised. I'm like, dude, just like from a mental image POV and just like communicating 400 is much. And again, Goswami is arguably along with Shefali Verma, probably there, the potential to like turn over the strike rate.
Hit out quickly.
So I was very surprised that they declared. But I mean, so far 69 for 2 is not too bad. In the last session, if they get a couple of wickets, then, I mean, again, I doubt there's going to be any result in this in any case, unfortunately. But
what was your opinion on this? I mean, obviously, because no DRS, the Poonam Raut walking, no blazers at the start, at the toss. What was your reaction to all of these things?
I mean, with the DRS, I was surprised by, but I don't know what the technology is, because I think even when I think Pakistan was scheduled to play, I don't know if it was the Pakistan that particular series or whatever it is, which got canned. I have a feeling that there was not going to be any DRS there as well, because I don't know, for whatever reason, I don't know what this DRS technology is that maybe
they, because they shifted grounds. It was supposed to be in Perth, and then because of COVID it was shifted to Karara or whatever, so in Queensland. So all the matches were played in Queensland. So I don't know, because of the kind of ground it is, whether technology wise DRS doesn't fit into the scheme of things or whatever. But I thought the blazer not being there was a kind of an important thing, I would have thought. I don't know whether we're just making a lot about it. The fact that at the toss, like, we didn't have it, Mithali Raj didn't have an Indian blazer, and her counterpart did. I mean, usually at the toss, you wear one, right? So then, of course, that narrative started about no one caring about Indian women's cricket teams. Vis-a-vis, obviously, the men are always well turned out. This would never happen if it was a men's team, obviously, blah, 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 blah. So, yeah.
You know, I mean, I honestly, I've been watching it on and off because, again, the rain keeps coming. Every time I tune on, it starts raining. And I'm like, maybe I'm causing it. So then I just stopped watching out of superstition. I'm like, maybe me watching the match is causing it to rain. But also, again, crazy amount of drops, man. Like, which is lots of missed chances. And again, I'm still this thing that they didn't get to 400. But I'm a big fan of Smriti Mandhana, super knock. Completely thoroughly enjoyed, man. I also like how, I think, I don't know if this is an inspiration from, because Shefali Verma's game, right, with that aggressive and all that kind of stuff, I really enjoy how she bats in tests, because it's so fascinating to see the transition from like, hey, I'm just going to go for it, to I'll wait for the next one. I'm like, I like it. It's great.
Yeah. Also, because Smriti Mandhana's strike rate was, I think she was at one point like at 90 or something. I think Shivali Verma must have been about 50 or something, which is very unlike her, right? It's very unlike her sort of innings. But also, I don't know what it is about left-handers. They just look so stylish when they bat. Like for me, it's just visually for me, I always find like southpaws are just fascinating to watch. There's like an X factor, you know?
Yeah.
When you watch a left-hander century, when you're watching those highlights, because I watched it about twice. It's just beautiful. Yeah.
So I bat right-handed, right? Like, as everybody obviously knows because of my immense talent as a cricketer. But I was once, I decided to bat left-handed because, like, people were just bowling, like, there were some shit bowlers like Sapana. And, dude, like, as a shitty, shitty left-hander, I hit a cover drive and I have never felt that good with any shot that I've ever hit in cricket. And it was like, I was just in this thing and in the arc, and you just feel like, oh, I'm flowing. So what I'm trying to say is that I'm the Smriti Mandhana of left-handed batting.
But also, I just want to know, like, how difficult, because I always find it fascinating when, I mean, some people obviously are ambidextrous like a Sachin Tendulkar, but some people have made that conscious decision, right? So Venki Iyer said after watching Sourav Ganguly that I'm going to bat left-handed. Which is, I just think it's a bizarre thing. Like in Nadal's case, he's right. His uncle made him play left-handed, saying that you get more revolutions per minute, like more spin when you play left-handed. So, I mean, there are various reasons. But I just wanted to know, like, what would... I mean, it's a bizarre thing, no? What would prompt you to suddenly say, no, now I'm just going to change?
It's such an interesting thing because, like, you know what, like, the what you just said about the person who bowls right-handed and then bats left-handed.
Yes.
I find that so interesting because when you think about it, like it's what Hayden used to say, right? Where he said that I'm right-handed and I bat left-handed, and I feel that it's because I feel like my right, when I'm facing the bowler, it's aligned in the correct direction for me, and that makes it easier for me to bat. Which I thought was a kind of interesting opinion. And like the few times that I've batted left-handed, I've realized that if you try to play even table tennis and all that kind of stuff left-handed, it's almost like you're playing a different game, you know? And if you had started to play that game and made that decision, like, I think the place that I used to play in my building, there were no runs on the leg side as a right-hander.
Okay.
You would get out. You could literally, the only option was to hit absolutely straight or to hit on the offside, right? And nobody used to bat left-handed. And I was like, this is absurd, dude. If there's one person who bats left-handed, they would absolutely go ballistic playing here. And then I met somebody who did, and we got them on three balls. But that's not the point. The point is that somebody could have made that change and gone like, oh, I can exploit this condition. So, yeah. Anyway, we have a few chats popping in. Human says, Dada's swagger would tempt anyone. How could Iyer resist? Absolutely makes sense.
That I completely agree. Yeah.
Yeah. Swaraj Chavan says, Mithali doesn't even have BCCI logo or an Indian flag on a helmet. And I've seen this for a long time. Is that true?
Really?
Yeah, I don't know. I'm not too sure about
okay.
that. Okay. Never noticed that. Somebody says that she forgot to wear it. Ferzi says they forgot to wear it. I don't even know what the story is.
Okay.
No idea about all of it. There's a couple of things more about the KKR match. Again, please give a like if you're enjoying. We have a lot more stuff to cover. We'll also come to today's match as well. I want to talk about... what have I missed out on? Dude, Arshdeep, man. What do you think of Arshdeep? That ball to get...
huge. What a yorker, yeah. What a yorker. Yeah. And also hugely improved bowler, no? That's what they were saying. Ek to again, left-handed bowler. So Irfan Pathan is clearly getting very excited watching him. But that's the thing, no? When you find range, that is so, I think, integral to IPL. And when everyone finds that slower ball or whatever works for you, you work on that range, it always goes in your favor. And I think it's amazing to watch. Like, it's almost like a different bowler, you know, watching him.
Yeah, because I think I remember the last, I don't know if this is a distinct change or whatever. I think when he was bowling, even in the first leg of the IPL, he was bowling about 132. And yesterday, he was bowling at 138, about 135 to 139, which is like, I mean, it sounds like a very minor thing, but it's a market change. And I was like, that's quite interesting. And also, dude, as a left-hander trying to get the ball back into a right-hander is what they all aspire towards. And then I remember when Stark was ineffective because he was not being able to do that for like a year and then finally got it back. So, yeah, everybody's talking. Let's cover this for a very quick second, okay? Who do you think, which player amongst all of these who you've seen on display, if they were released into the auction, when the auction rolls out, because everybody's talking about Venki Iyer getting a stupid amount of money, and I don't think he will, because I think KKR will retain him. Like, it seems like
a no-brainer. Yeah, for sure.
Yeah, yeah. There's no way he's going to go out into the auction. So according to me, the player who KKR is going to retain, and tell me if I'm right, tell me if you agree, Venki Iyer, Russell, obviously. And I would say Varun Chakravarti.
You don't think they're going to retain Sunil Narine?
I mean, it's a long call, no? Because it's 3 years now.
Yeah. I mean, I don't see them not retaining. You think they won't retain Shubman Gill?
That's what I'm saying. Even Shubman Gill and DK, right, who've been integral to them, their plans for quite a few years now. It's kind of interesting. And you know what? It seems like these kind of conversations, right? Like, I'm sure they must be having backstage, and I'm quite curious how it affects like an on-field thing. Okay, I'm saying, okay, logically, basis on...
You need DK there because he has to play peacemaker, no? And you need him to speak in Tamil also to Varun Chakravarti. So, you'll need to retain DK anyway, I think. Just for his translation skills and for his UN messenger of peace skills.
Yeah.
So, anytime Owen wants to shout at someone else, then, you know, about spirit of cricket, then DK is there for spirit reasons.
By the way, Sehwag completely disagrees. Sehwag is blaming DK for this whole mess about that run thing. About that extra run.
Where did he blame Sehwag? I mean, where did he blame DK?
He said that it's all Dinesh Karthik's fault for even bringing this up in the post-match conference.
He was asked about it, I thought.
That's what I'm saying. And I'm like, well, that's quite a strange thing to say. But I'm like, he's asked, obviously he's going to say it. Well, what else do you want him to say?
Yeah, and he was quite politically correct, I thought, in how he handled it. But, you know, and someone tweeted to me, which I found very fascinating, about how, after reading Ashwin's thread, you know, how he's such an aggressive personality and he's complained about Kohli. You know, no wonder, you know, Tim Payne said behind the stumps in Australia, I have more friends in the Indian dressing room than you have. And it's true because he's such a confrontational, aggressive person. I was like, he's in the same team as Virat Kohli and Ashwin is a confrontational, aggressive one.
I think it's because like nobody wants to fuck with Kohli, right? Like nobody, because like you just never know how it's going to come out. And it seems like they feel like more comfortable messing with Ashwin because as a bowler, right? Again, it's the thing about like not messing with a pace bowler, right? Because you don't want to piss off a pace bowler because they'll bounce you out. As a spinner, like, okay, you'll get me out. That's it, right? And we will probably get them out as he did.
Your words only are bouncers.
Yeah, his words are bouncers. Okay, I'll take a few chats. People are like, I would love to know what people think about who they'll retain. Teja Surya says Varun will be retained. He also says Varun will go huge in the auction. I think they allowed three, right? Dhruv Mitra says the test is draw between India and Australia. I'm sure it will be, but you never know. I hope some twists happen. Ridge DX says leg bye should be banned in the name of spirit of cricket. I agree. I think leg bye should be banned. Runouts should also be banned. And I think just...
Why should runouts be banned?
Everything should be banned in cricket. I think the spirit of cricket should be that you should just be allowed to hit fours and sixes and nothing else should be allowed. Like even running a three, right? It's hard on the scorer because you have to find that extra three and do calculations and multiples of three are hard to do. So I'm just saying that make it easier for the batter and just like it should all be about everybody should score 300 runs. That is the true spirit of cricket.
For me, forget everything else. I just wanted to laugh when Shane Warne became all holier than thou about this. Okay. And I was like, Shane Warne, you were banned for using substances, which you claimed that it was a diuretic because you wanted to lose weight. I said, yeah, Liz Hurley ke saath wo pressure mein aaya. Kya tu? That you had to lose weight. So just, you know, no one should be extra virtuous because every action of yours or past statement of yours will come to bite you in the ass. So just take a deep breath and calm yourself.
Dude, but I, you know what, I really enjoy, like, I enjoy people like Shane Warne and KP and all these opinionated people. It's such a joy because, like, with a lot of people holding their cards close to their chest, like, Shane Warne is always, like, just trying to poke the bear. And, you know, when you think about it, okay, when you think about it, Ashwin is, in a very roundabout way, the Shane Warne of this current generation. Both in wicket-taking ability, both in arguably being the greatest spinner out there right now, which certain people in the Indian team management disagree with, and also just getting into these kind of things constantly. Like so when Shane Warne tweeted that out, in my head I was like, shit man, do you realize he's you? He's literally you.
You're talking like about Shane Warne's nickname was Hollywood. Right, his nickname is Hollywood, yeah. So, I was like, in Ashwin's case, what are you going to call him? Hollywood, like, in that analogy. Just, yeah, it's the same thing. No, he has this amazing way to find himself in these contracts. I'm not saying no. But I just feel this moralistic high ground of spirit, something should not be played in the spirit, considering all that has happened with your own World Cup victory against New Zealand. I don't think you should be taking this high road here. But again, you're entitled to your opinion. That's great. if you got some runs and then were virtuous, I would appreciate it a little more. But with your average of 5.8, apart from that 40 odd runs, which made it go to 10, I really don't think you should be so vocal, Oin.
Yeah, I think everybody should be vocal. I think it makes it way more interesting. Just speak whatever you want. Make it more interesting so that people like us have shit to talk about. Shivam Kangsab Banik says Varun Russell and Venki Iyer should be retained. I think that would be my list as well. I think if it's supposed to be three. But to belabor this point, if nobody ever gets retained, okay, who do you think, like, which of the younger players? It's got to be Venki Iyer, right? To be get the highest
for sure
bid, right? Who's second though? Who's second?
To get the highest just in terms of moolah, like who's going to go for the most, like that.
Yeah.
I don't know because he's just so far ahead. Like the others are there, but they're not up there yet in terms of, like, this has been like a breakout performance, right?
Correct.
Like best debut, etc. Your Filmfare Award. I don't know who else would you say would go for a lot.
So I have just opened the list of, like, basically the stats. Okay, so Gaikwad for sure, 100%. Rahul Tripathi, as well. I would also say obviously Padikkal, and I would say Arshdeep is right up there as well. And
okay.
Tell me if you agree with this. Okay. Everybody's been talking about, hey, this player should make it to the Indian side and blah 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 based on current performance. Nobody talks about Harshal Patel. And I find that a little surprising.
Because, true.
Like, I find it genuinely surprising that Harshal Patel is not in the mix for, like, literally a place in the Indian side on the back of this ridiculous performance, dude. Like, again, I'm going through the numbers, okay? Just to go through this. He is 8 wickets ahead of the closest person, which is Avishkar.
Yeah.
In the 26 wickets in 11 matches, and nobody says that this guy should be in the T20 side for the World Cup is ridiculous to me.
I don't think they can. Yeah, I mean, that is bizarre. But I also feel like definitely with this whole selection also, that has created another, like, opened another can of worms in that. Why is Hardik Pandya there if he's not in form? He's not even being playing consistently for Mumbai Indians. He's not going to bowl in a while. So then why are we selecting this person for, you know, but also the selection is happening way before. So, look, I think it's too early for Venki Iyer to... You can't debut for India in the T20. I think it would be a bit much. So you've got to blood them somewhere else before, you know, a tournament of this sort of magnitude. But yeah, it is. I mean, I think Harshad Patel is definitely the one knocking at the door against the current crop of Indian pacers, right? Followed by an Avesh Khan, I would say.
Yeah, probably. People are saying Rohit Soria says Harshal is lucky. Yeah, after 26 wickets in 11 matches, he's lucky. He has absolutely no talent. He's just like, he just happens to be getting the ball. Dude, that hat-trick, okay? I don't think I've seen a more skillful hat-trick in the IPL. Like, that was a ridiculous hat-trick which he took, like, I mean, that ball to Kieran Pollard, where Pollard was like, huh? Like, it was exactly like DK and Morgan getting out. But they're like, wait, did that happen? Like, yeah, it did, dude. So I think
Gujarat didn't select him to play for them. That's why he had to go to Haryana. Harshal Patel.
Harshal Patel's statistics would be read properly. Out of 26 wickets, most have come from tail-enders. Yeah, Pollard is a tail-ender, as we all know. Quite a few. I think somebody should do the stats. And by the way, if you've taken a lot of wickets, 95% of bowlers who've taken a substantial amount of wickets, especially at the top tier on in any tournament, it would be tail-enders because you take them in a bunch. You would take, I don't necessarily agree.
There is that stat also, no? Between 16 and 20 overs in the IPL, he has taken the most number of wickets as well.
Correct. Yeah. Okay, let's come to today's match, which is, of course, MI versus Delhi Capitals.
DC, yeah.
Yeah, but you know what? Before that, I want to quickly just talk about the statement. I forwarded this to you, okay? I'll just read the teams for today and then we'll just come to the statement. Prithvi Shaw is in for Lalit Yadav, no surprise there. And Jayant Yadav is in for Rahul Chahar. That's a surprise. Is it because of the left-handers and stuff? Probably. I'm assuming that's it. Shikhar Dhawan, Rishabh Pant, Shimran.
I feel Aspire. If anyone should feel hard done by with this World Cup team selection, I feel really bad for Shikhar Dhawan if we're going to talk about.
Yeah.
I feel he should have been in the team.
Yeah, I agree. So DC is going to be batting first, which should be kind of interesting. Okay, but one thing on the side which has happened.
No, DC chose to field, Baba.
DC chose to field. Sorry, yeah, okay, huh.
Okay.
Okay, what am I saying? Yeah. What do you think about this whole conversation about the Ashes right now? Because Tim, I enjoyed Tim Payne's statement, but he said the Ashes will continue whether Joe Root is on the plane or no. And I'm like, yeah, I don't think you can have the Ashes without the other side. I think that's pretty tough to have the Ashes by yourself. Like, this is not the early 2000s where you'll have Australia A versus Australia as the Ashes. That's not an option, Tim Payne. Like, think a little bit. So,
let's just recruit a team from South Africa, because at one point, half of South Africa was playing for England anyway. So, ki farak penda, and just get them to,
And talking about South Africans playing for England, Kevin Peterson said that there is no way I would go to the Ashes this winter. Zero chance unless the ridiculous quarantine rules were squashed and my family could travel with zero restrictions. Players are now done with the bubbles, done. And honestly, you have to thoda agree, dude. It's like the Ashes is not a short tour. It's not like four T20s or something. It's like a lot.
He's been very vocal and very passionate about this for a long time, saying that the World T20 will be the last tournament held with such a strict bubble. He's like, now we've gotten to the stage where everyone is double vaccinated. You know, you should be able. You can't do like 1.5 years of this is impossible. And I mean, it's hardly surprising also now Chris Gayle, universe boss, saying, okay, screw this, I'm out of here. You know, like you're hardly even yesterday when KL Rahul they were saying, you know, when you thought about team composition, he was like, you have to think, no, after, of course, Chris left. I can't tell whether he was upset, relieved. You can't tell from KL Rahul's expressions or the lack thereof. So yeah, like no one's going to be able to put up with it for too long.
Yeah.
But also KP and Piers Morgan think very similarly. So I think that's the scary part. They're both equally passionate about the things they want to talk about.
Kevin Peterson is the Piers Morgan of cricket is an interesting one. And by the way, Tim Payne responded to this saying, if you want to know anything on any topic in the world, you just ask Kevin Peterson. He's an expert on anything. I thoroughly enjoy this. Like I like how even when Kevin Peterson is retired and out of cricket, he's still figuring out a way to get into the Australian's head. Like he's still fucking with them. It's thoroughly enjoyable. Completely love it. By the way, I started listening to Tim Payne's radio show, which is very interesting. I think it's him and this Aussie rules football player doing this together, and they're very like gung-ho about things. And it's very fascinating.
Do they just chat or do they interview people or what is it? They discuss all sport or just...
Sometimes they have other people popping in who I don't even know. It's like if somebody without context would tune into like start watching Big Boss, right? Like somebody from Australia would watch Big Boss and you'd be like, yeah, I recognize like say Saurav Ganguly or whatever if he's in Big Boss. But I have no idea who like any of these... Who's Krishna Abhishek? I have no idea. It's like that when I'm... Listen to this. But what do you think? You think that that Australia is going to sort of change the rules just for the Ashes?
No chance. Like half the country is not vaccinated yet. What are they going to do? It's not like... like people can... Like KP and stuff can say these things because they're coming from a country where mostly everyone is vaccinated. That's not the case in Australia and New Zealand, right? So they're still in a heavy lockdown phase. So they're not, they can't take the chance. Yeah? That'll be even worse if something happens, right?
Yeah, correct. So I mean, because even when I was talking to Melinda Farrell, she said it took like a stupid amount of time for her to even get that second vaccine. So you can understand the paranoia and all that kind of stuff. Because again, as we've noticed with this, it takes like one, and by the way, I reached my hotel today. Hotel, sorry. That's what I'm supposed to say.
Hotel. Hotel.
What do I say? Hotel.
Hotel.
And I mean, the number of people, like, okay, I can understand where the relief sometimes with putting the mask on your nose and all that stuff for like a few like seconds or whatever. Dude, everybody was doing this. Like, it was like watching a parody video of COVID protocol where every single person in the lobby has got the thing here. And I was like, what is this, man? Anyway, it's a great hotel, guys. Hotel. Today is of course DC versus Mumbai Indians. What are the rules? DC is through. I think Mumbai Indians really need to
DC is through on the back of Punjab winning yesterday. So with a little help from my friend. So that's that. But now what? MI has to win all their games. Now it's an exciting thing, no, for those last two spots.
Dude, but by the way, Surya Kumar Yadav's form, okay, in the last five matches, he's got 19 runs. I mean, who, like, this is like some Owen Morgan numbers we're talking about.
Yeah.
Like, and I was watching him bat against Sri Lanka. And when he like does his thing, right, with the I'm Surya Kumar Yadav, Mehuna, and all that kind of stuff, it's amazing to watch. But then it's not working. It looks like the exact opposite. Where I'm like, dude, just eat the chewing gum. Just eat it. There's no point. But
you mean just swallow it? What do you mean just eat it? He is chewing it, you fool.
Whatever. I don't know, man. Make a bubble.
There was an analogy there that you've completely somehow messed up.
but what does everybody think of Sky's form right now? It also raises, I mean, there's a lot of questions about, dude, everybody who's been selected for the Indian team.
In the valley of their form as opposed to the mountain of their form currently. No one's even plateauing in terms of form. I just think the Indian team needs a Pandya brother cleanse at some point. Can we just, you know, like people go for Vipassana and all. No, to that, I feel like it's important for everyone's sake.
Yeah, yeah. So there's nobody in the side. Like, I think barring Kohli, who's killing it right now. Hey, Coulton Ayle is still playing. So Jayawardhane has said, and I would love to know what everybody thinks about this. Jayawardhane has said that we don't want to rush Pandya into bowling because that might affect his batting.
Yeah.
Which, I don't understand what that means. Like, is he batting while bowling? Is he bowling to himself? I'm not understanding. Is he going to get injured?
Did you also see the spelling error? Like, when I think ESPN, they said something about it'll be an issue. And they had said it'll be in a shoe. Okay. So Jimmy Neesham replied and said, I don't think it'll be in a shoe because I don't think size 12 will make a difference to his batting or bowling.
Yeah,
I enjoy this Jimmy Neesham a great deal. His tweets are really funny.
Yeah, I tweeted to him once and he gave a very confused reply because he's like, what are you talking about, dude? Which is this is what I do. I get into cricketers' DMs and weird replies all the time.
To confuse them.
Completely confuse them. David Joneja says Bumrah and Jaddu killing it, bro. Yeah. So there's Bumrah, there's Jaddu, there is Kohli. And everybody else is... and KL Rahul, of course. How can you forget KL Rahul? So there's actually four.
See, Bhuvaneshwar Kumar also is not having a great time. That's another this thing. Yeah.
Averaging 27 with the bat. 56.
Okay.
There you go.
Okay, cool. So that's why he's there in his capacity.
He's there as a batsman who occasionally bowls.
Batsman extraordinaire who can bowl a bit.
Yeah. He is the Pandya they need. Okay. Prateek Gaushinde says, I still can't believe why Saurabh Pant is not part of Hotstar. Those perfect combo of comedy and cricketing knowledge. Did he not try to get that gig or was not selected? They offered me. And I just said, this is not enough. You know, I'm just... I come for a very high price. And the high price, of course, was offered by Cuckoo FM, who's our sponsor. So Cuckoo FM is my Hotstar. Just want to say that thanks to Cuckoo FM for supporting the show. And you can get discounts on Gandhi Jayanti for 50% off using the code. Wait, I'm going to say the code now, which is, where's it gone? Gandhi 50, which is only valid on 1st to 3rd October. Anyway, so I hope that answers your question about Hotstar Dost. I nailed the audition, twice, both times. I was incredible. There was laughter everywhere. In fact, one of the people involved said that, Saurabh, you know what? You're so good at this. Forget Hotstar Dost. You should be selected for the Indian team on the basis of these auditions. But I just said, no, let young people like Amit Tandon and all of these people get an opportunity to make some money because Tandon never gets selected for any OTT shows. So I just thought he requires this kind of break. So I just said no and passed.
I appreciate whoever asked this question because this has suddenly turned into a therapy session. And now you understand why Saurabh doesn't even have real life Dosts. I just want to say, regardless of whether they're hot stars or not.
Prateek believes it. Okay. We have two super chats popping in. Again, we have 10 minutes before the match begins. We'll do a couple more and I'll seize about it. But yeah, I also want to talk about, let's take a couple of chats. Ankit Kumar says, do you guys think India's squad can change post-IPL? Of course. I think 100%. What do you think? Yes, right? 10th October is the date.
10th, yeah, yeah. 10th is it. We're starting 15th. The World Cup is starting 15th. So I'm sure there's some, I think even Abhijit, there was some, not if something happens, untoward happens, beach may also the tournament, then you can send in reinforcements or change things around or whatever.
Yeah.
Like we were saying, we're going in with three pacers, right? And quite frankly, on these, no one expected the tracks to be the way they are. The fact that in last time IPL was played on Sharjah, those sort of like 300 runs per inning sort of track, now to the ball slowing down so drastically after those first 10 overs. So they're completely different tracks this time.
Yeah, I definitely foresee. I would say there would be probably three changes. Is my prediction. I don't know who yet. Rahul Chahar was a good selection, but now again Chahal is out bowling him, which makes all of this very interesting. And again, it all depends on how much faith you have in a particular player. Where do you believe that this person will sort of reaffirm your faith in them and all that kind of stuff?
Because right now, their three reserves are Shardul Thakur, Shreyas Iyer and Deepak Chahar.
Yeah. Yeah. Okay. Krishna Kanth Bachu says, is Chahal not to be deserved in T20 squad? Not on the basis of that current form, but now current form, probably. But again, I'm not sure that they even... I think this is honestly, this announcement of the squad... was just something that the ICC mandated, so they just went ahead and made it. I'm not sure how seriously they're even going to take it. Or maybe they will, who knows. But yeah, even Deepak Chahar not being there was I thought, a bit of a surprise to me. Because again, especially in T20s, he bowled well in Sri Lanka, won that match for us out of nowhere.
And he can bat also.
Yeah, there you go. So Deepak Chahar, basis current from Deepak Chahar over Bhuvi, Chahal over Chahar, etc. So there's a lot of combos popping out. But again, I mean, as everybody's proven, is that recency bias exists. So yeah. What else is there? Pratik Kaushandya says, I definitely find Abhishek Upamani stand-up videos, but clearly he doesn't belong there on Hotstar. Oh, okay. I wasn't meant to read that. I read that by mistake. I thought he was saying something else.
I haven't watched much of this those thing, but clearly people are very passionate about it.
I think what people expect is that you're expecting everybody to be as unhinged as and uncensored as you would expect from, say, a YouTube live or something like that, which is never going to happen. You're aiming for a way bigger market where way bigger people will have constant problems about way bigger things. And so you have to appeal to that. So I think that with Hotstar, those, the big advantage that they have is that I have a feeling that it's going to actually induce a lot more people to watch the IPL just because they are a fan of XYZ. Whether you're a fan of Gujarat or whatever. So I don't think that's...
Are you trying to tell me in a cricket crazy country, because you're following one comedian, you're going to watch him do Hotstar dose because you don't follow cricket otherwise, but because he's talking about it, you're going to follow it in a non-stand-up video? Really?
Yeah. I generally think so. I think because I've heard 3-4 people say that we tuned in because of Gujarat, specifically. I would say Gujral, Upamanyu and Zakir. So that's been... and a lot of people tuned out because they saw Angad. This is also a fact. People saw Angad's face and they're like, fuck this guy. Which is my attitude as well.
They're showing faces and all. I didn't see that.
Let's see any other chats, anything we've missed out. But they're performing in the same grounds as World Cup is going to play in 15-20 days. This performance should be taken seriously. It says David Juneja. Dude, what do you think? How do you think the pitches are going to be by the time the World Cup rolls around? Because the more I'm...
tired, fatigued, fed up.
I think they're going to be like European Cricket League. I think they'll have to start getting matted wickets just to make something happen.
Even you, the one who put up that tweet about some Finland versus England thing with some 8 slips.
Yeah. It's very enjoyable, dude, because I don't know why he did it only on the last ball. And the batter would have felt like such an ass for missing that. And by the way, there's a leg slip as well. So they were technically 9 slips, is what somebody told me. 9 slips. Nine just slips. Just to fuck with people's head. I completely thoroughly enjoyed it.
This is why Finland, the happiness index is very high in that country, because they allow you to do whatever they want. So last ball.
Yeah. And also, by the way, Finland also, even the dude who's bowling, like, he seemed like subcontinental origin type of person.
Obviously, who's going to take up some, which Nordic looking person is going to take up cricket in Finland and Norway?
It's so absurd that, like, whichever country you go to, whether it's Finland or Papua New Guinea, how do you say
Papua New Guinea?
Papua New Guinea. Like, everybody, there's like Indians everywhere, like, there'll be a thing who'll pop up.
Yeah,
like, this is amazing, dude. Like, we're not inducing new people in, we are just inducing us from other places. That's it.
You know, I met this Indian dude from the West Indies. Who said, you know, a lot of them went as their forefathers went as indentured labor and all of that, right? And so they said they all had to sign on there. And a lot of them couldn't read and write properly, which is why, like, the Pals became Pauls and all of that, right? And the spellings all over. He said, but if you ask me technically, so they follow traditions and things. But if you ask me, I don't know which part of India we're from. Because now they're fourth generation, fifth generation. So he's like, I actually have no idea. So it's a generic sort of idea of India, but technically from where, they don't know, which I thought was quite fascinating.
Yeah. I mean, and again, you're from wherever. Yeah, the world is a big place.
Absolutely.
Who do you think is going to win? DC versus Mumbai Indians? Who do you think is going to win? By the way, we have a compliment coming in for you, Anu, which is George says, I watch Anu's commentary and interviews. Don't watch the IPL. Only follow scores.
Wow. Thanks, dost.
By the way, Mohammed Saqib says Papua New Guinea has good local people in the team. I'm sure there is a Singh somewhere. There has to be a Singh, there has to be a Shah.
Others, can we even take them seriously? No. We like the English team because Monty Panesar was there.
Okay, who do you think? DC versus MI, who do you think is going to win today?
Well, I mean, quite frankly, this MI always love to do this. Now, love to leave things to the last minute. That's really exciting. Then they'll come hell or high water. They'll make it into the last four. And I'm quite happy if they don't win. I'm like fed up now. Enough. Bahut ho chuka.
This is fed up.
I really like Rohit. I really like, enough now. I'm tired of your monopoly. I want CSK to win this thing. Say bye to Dhoni. We'll all cry and then we'll try and move on.
Yeah, but see, listen, if you're talking about crying, right, wouldn't you cry more if he lost and then left?
No. I want to cry happy tears and wave goodbye. Okay, that's what I want. I don't want him to leave in the middle of the IPL next season, suddenly drop a bomb like he did in Australia and then walk out.
Yeah, which I still found that quite absurd. Where it's like, it's the middle of a test series. See you later.
Toodles.
Like, dude, there's a test series. What are you talking about, dude? Like, everybody who's criticizing Virat Kohli right now is like, Dhoni doing that in the middle of a test series in Australia is totally fine. Anyway, yesterday somebody was asking what this is. My wife bought mehendi, and this is what my daughter made on my hand. This is supposed to be a sun, and this is supposed to be a star. So I'm just saying that that's the artistic.
Hey, that's hot mehendi. And star. Do you get it?
Oh, shit. Oh,
yeah, I'm a very deep layered person. So nuanced.
It was almost in my hands, but then not exactly. Who do you think is going to win? Let's take the chats. Is Kuldeep Yadav?
I'm going to say DC.
DC, yeah. I think DC batting first. You know what? I think it would be more interesting if MI won. So I'm going
to
say MI.
DC chose to field. Stop saying they're batting first.
So DC is going to be batting first, and they're also going to be batting second. It's one of the first times in the IPL that's going to happen. They're just going to bat against themselves.
You think Gautam Gambhir ever smiles? Yesterday with Graham Swan, I was just watching him, dude, and I was thinking, you will never wrinkle because you never smile.
At 86, and somebody's like, Papa, Grandpapa. Dadaji, why you never recall? He's like, I have never smiled. Dude, he made a joke that day. I was very amazed by it.
What was the joke?
So the joke was that they asked him, I think CSK was playing against, who were they playing when Dhoni hit that six? I've completely blacked out.
Yeah, something wrong with me also. Huh? Say.
So I think CSK was on top, and then they do that thing in the dugout where they're like, hey, which captain would you want to be? And Gambhir was like, I'd definitely be Dhoni. And then they asked him, they're like, so what would you do if you're Dhoni? He's like, I would just drink some soup and say, you finish it off. And everybody laughed.
Against SRH.
And I'm like, wow, Gambhir is making jokes and all, dude. Like, it's incredible. Gambhir made a joke. I was shocked. Like, I think the IPL shut down the moment that happened. Okay. Apparently, something's already happened in the first ball. First ball, etc. Okay. Ankit Kumar says, Rohit Sharma, my captain for today's Dream 11. Absolutely do that, man. Okay, that's about it. I think now it's time to watch the match. Just a couple of things before I head out is that, of course, Cuckoo FM, thanks a lot for subscribing, for sponsoring us. Leading vernacular audio podcasting medium. I generally checked out a lot of fun stuff. If you want to thrillers. Oh, I forgot to talk about the romantic. There's a romantic, erotic story in Hindi, which involved a shower. I will not reveal more. But it was I was taking a walk and listening, and I was like, I should go to a shower now. So check it out. They also have summaries in Hindi of multiple motivational books, etc. Quite interesting stuff. The coupon codes are SP20 for a lifetime 20% discount on your annual subscription of INR 399 or limited edition Gandhi 50. All of this is going to be in the description, including the app link, which is from 1st to 3rd of October. Subscribers get 50% off. My goodness, that is amazing. Totally, yaar. Please go do it, guys. Anyway, that's about it. Anu, anything coming up that you like to talk about? Anything?
No, no, not at all. Not at all.
Yeah. Third wicket down for Australia the test. Not bad. Yeah. Cool. So I'll be back tomorrow. I think most likely Bhaskar is going to join me. And again, tonight, if you're in Gurgaon, please come. In Delhi tonight is Happy High at 6 o'clock and 9:15. I'm at Helium Comedy Club. And then tomorrow, I'm going to be in Gurgaon at Piano Man at 4 p.m. And then Furball at 7:30. And next weekend is Hyderabad. That's about it. Anumanan, it's a pleasure talking to yourself.
Thanks, yeah. And I'll see you soon. Like this. Hopefully.
Like people we'll see. Anyway, take care, everybody watching. Thanks to all my mods, Dhanush, Sharanya, everybody. I really appreciate it. I'm ending the meeting. Love you all.